Hello, hello. Welcome back to my channel. Today, we are just going to jump right into it because this is serious stencil business. So one of my favorite things to do with Cricut is to make stencils, and they're super intimidating, but they're so, so easy. So let's get right into it. So first, we're going to start out in Design Space. So we are going to make a stencil that says Merry Christmas, and I'm going to put it on a wooden circle. So this first font here is Market Street Fonts. And then this down here is actually an SVG that I got from Cricut. So to find that, I just went to images, I searched for Christmas, and then they have a bunch of different Christmas words here that I thought were super cute. So I just scrolled down and I think it is, yeah, this one right here. And then for the Mary, all I did was create a text box and I searched for the Market Street fonts. Oh, this is the Early Bird font that I just love. It's so cute. And I just typed in Mary. Okay, so now that we have our two words, I'm actually going to create two separate stencils because I'm not sure exactly where I want to put this on the circle yet. So I'm going to come over here and first we are going to make a square using the shapes button. So I'm just going to click that, select square. I'm just going to move the Christmas out of the way. So what we want to do is we basically want to put this over our word so it is completely covered. So to do that, I'm going to come down here and click the lock button. And the reason we're going to do that is because right now, if I were to size this, all I can do is size it this way. But if I click on the lock, now this lights up green and now I can really manipulate the shape however I want it. All right, so now we're just gonna place it over our word. And so if you are new at stencils, I would recommend giving yourself a good border around your word. And I'll send this to the back so you can kind of see what we're doing. All right, so once you have your square or your stencil piece as big as you want it, all we're gonna do is I'm gonna hold down my mouse, drag over both the word and the square, and come down here and click slice once it lights up. So let me show you again. So right now, slice is not lit up. I'm gonna hold down, drag, and now it's lit up. So we're gonna click slice, and then all you do is move away the layers that it has sliced out, and you're left with a stencil. So we're gonna do the same exact thing for our Christmas down here. I'm gonna create a square. I'll send this to the back so you can see what we're doing. And I'm gonna unlock it, and I'm just going to move it all the way over my font. Now I'm gonna hold and drag and slice and move the layers away, and you are left with two stencils. So a couple of tips with making stencils. One, if you are typing out, typing out a script font like this one, you're gonna want to ungroup it and move all your letters together like you would with any script font. And you're gonna need to weld it before you make your stencil. So now it's ready to go. And the reason I bring that up is because you can only slice one thing at a time. So if I were to try and slice all of these letters individually, Cricut's not going to let me. You have to have everything welded together. Or if you're trying to do multiple stencils, you have to do one stencil at a time. All right, so that is basically it. So I'm going to come over here to make it. So you can see we have our two stencils here. Hit continue. So I'm going to use my maker for this, and the settings I'm going to use are the vinyl setting, but I'm going to use more pressure because I am cutting this out of stencil film and I feel like the vinyl setting doesn't cut through it all the way. So if I give it a little more pressure, it works a little bit better for me. So I'll switch you guys over to the camera so you can see how we're going to make it. Okay, so for this stencil, I'm going to be using this Oramask 813 stencil film. So Auntie Tay sent this to me. She does sell it on her website. I know it's available other places too, but that is where I got mine for this. So that's where I got this gigantic roll from. So you can always get 10% off her shop if you use my code thecraftscraps, all lowercase. This isn't sponsored by her, but this is where I got this roll of film. So I am just going to cut out what I need. And you guys, I'm not going to lie to you because, you know, I try to be transparent and honest. So I'm going to tell you, I actually filmed this to a certain point and I stopped and I refilmed it, and I'll tell you why. I'm not done, but I made this stencil already. So Merry Christmas. So that's the stencil we're making, right? But I realized once I weeded all this, you guys can't see what I'm doing. Okay. So I was like, okay, that's whatever. But then I'm like, I'm then going to put this white stencil on this white circle. No one's going to be able to see what I'm doing. So here we are, round two, and we're going to be using stencil film that you can actually see what I'm doing. I'm just going to put this on my mat. And stencil film can be super temperamental, but I want you guys to know that it is easier than you think to work with. When I first started working with stencil film, when it cuts, it like bubbles, and then, you know, like the stencil film can bubble, but do not think it's ruined. You can still 100,000,000% use it. When I first started, I got all this stencil film and it was all bubbled, and I was like, what is the point of this? And I ended up like throwing it all away. All right, so now we can load our mat. So to load our mat, all we need to do is put our mat under these little teeth, and then once this starts blinking, you press the button, and as you're pressing it, it will feed into the machine. And then once our Cricut light starts blinking like it is right now, we can press that and start to cut. Alright, so we can click that same arrow button to unload our mat. And so now I'm going to just take the vinyl off of my mat. So I like to just flip it around and kind of more like peel the mat off the vinyl, just so it doesn't curl too much. All right, and so now I'm just gonna trim away the excess so I can use it for something else. And so see, this is what I mean about the stencil film. See, it's like all bubbled, but it's not ruined. You can just press it down and it's good as new. And I'm just gonna separate my stencils. And so now I'm just gonna weed away the parts of my stencil that we don't need. So first I'm gonna get rid of the border around it because we don't need that. And so when I say weed, all I mean is we're just going to get rid of basically, or weed out everything we don't need. So for a stencil, the whole point is that you're left with negative space that's where you put the paint in. So I'm gonna actually be getting rid of the letters inside my stencil. So the font that I used for the Mary has this little like detail on the inside, so that I'm gonna leave. But the rest of the letter, I'm going to get rid of. So again, just getting rid of the letters that I don't need. All right, so we have our Mary stencil. So now we're gonna do the same thing with our Christmas stencil. So getting rid of the border that we don't need. And now we're going to just weed away our Christmas. So I just started up here and I'm peeling away the C. And so with script, it's kind of nice because you can, if your vinyl works with you or your stencil film works with you, you can kind of get rid of everything with one pass. So just make sure that any of like the insides of your letters, like see this like little inside of this R, inside of this H, just make sure, we want to make sure those stay intact. All right, I'm gonna get rid of that because it was getting kind of intense. So now I'm still just pulling away the letters. All right, so we are left with our two stencils, Mary and Christmas. All right, and so this is the circle I'm gonna be putting it on. I tried to use a staple gun on it, and just so note to self, these do not withstand staples. So I just made this bow, and it's not pretty, it's not professional, it's kind of a joke, but I still think it's kind of cute. So I'm just gonna put this bow like right over here to kind of like cover those ugly staples, and then I'm gonna do my stencil. I'm gonna do Mary here, and then I'm gonna do Christmas down here. So I think it'll look cute. So I'm not gonna glue this down just yet because I don't wanna get paint on it, but I'm just gonna leave it kind of right here for now just to make sure I know where my stencils are going. So I'm gonna be using this Expressions vinyl transfer tape. Again, this was sent to me from Auntie Tay. All right, so I'm just going to tear off a piece. And this is like the original roll she sent me probably, like at least a year ago, and I still have so much left. Okay. All right, so I'm just gonna apply my transfer, and you could use any transfer tape. Sorry, I should have said that. You could use any kind of transfer tape. This is just one I prefer to use. So I'm just going to place it on my stencil. Didn't tear off a big enough piece, but that's all right. As long as it covers like the majority of your stencil, you're fine. So I'm just going to scrape it on there. And then I'm just gonna peel off the backing. So I like to flip over this, or if I do this even with vinyl, I like to flip it over and kind of just peel the backing off. All right. So I think I'm gonna have the bow like here. All right, so I think I'm gonna, like have the bow here, and then I'm gonna do the Mary. I'm not gonna press this down just yet because I want to make sure I get everything on there where I want it first. All right, and so then I'm gonna do the same thing with the Christmas down here. All right, so same thing for our Christmas stencil. I'm just going to tear off a piece. And place it on. And I'm just gonna peel off the backing. And so you just wanna make sure that nothing is left on your carrier sheet. And then let's see. All right, so now I have this placed where I want it. So I'm just going to, I like to kind of put the middle down first, and I can move this bow now. And I'm just going to scrape up, and just so I make sure this doesn't move, I'm gonna like press down the center. And so now I'm gonna scrape the bottom down. And just make sure it's really on there, nice and smooth. And so now I'm gonna do the same thing here. I like to do the middles first and then kind of work my way out. All right, so now we can peel off our transfer tape. Oop. And I like to kind of like press and peel it, just so make sure nothing comes up. All right, so this one I'm just going to peel. Alright, so now that we have our stencil on, I'm going to be going in with this Artist Loft acrylic paint. So I'm just going to put some on my little scrap paper over here. And so the trick with stencils to make sure you're not going to get any bleeding is to make sure you start off with very light coats of paint. So I'm just using this like janky sponge brush, but if you have better brushes, please feel free to do so. And also with any letters like this M that has like this pointy part, I think the M and like the I down here, I like to brush up. I don't want to brush down because I don't want to like peel away that little part. So I'm just going to kind of like lightly go in. So again, just start out with a light coat of paint. You can always go in with more. And make sure you don't like go outside of your stencil border. So, and if you get any on your hands like I just did, make sure you're just careful where you put your hands. So stencils can be pretty temperamental, but once you get the hang of it, it's gonna be like a piece of cake. So again, I'm just kind of going in here lightly with my first round of paint. All right, so now I'm gonna go in down for my Christmas stencil. And don't worry, I'm gonna go over this with more coats of paint. I just like to start out with a super light one first and then go back for more. All right, so now I'm gonna go back up to my Mary and put another coat of paint. And we're gonna peel this while it's still wet. We're not gonna wait for it to dry because that's when you can get it to crack and such. And so if you really want to like be careful, I should have done a bigger stencil border up here, but that's all right. So now I'm going to go back down here and do my Christmas one again. All right, and now I'm going to go in for my last round of paint up here. And again, like I said, you can really go in as many times as you want. It just depends, you know, what look you're going for. All right, so now let's go in for our final round for our Christmas. All right, so now this is like the moment of truth. We are gonna peel away and see. So what, I mean, there's no like magic to this part. I'm just gonna start peeling away our stencil just by picking up a corner. And so that's why I like the stencil film too. It like peels away so like easily. So I got some red up here. So I'm gonna see if I can. Now, you know, actually I'll just go back in with white paint because I painted this, so it'll be super easy. So now we're gonna go in with the Christmas. All right, so now I'm just gonna go back in and get all of these parts that are left, like the insides of the M and the R. So I'm just gonna use my weeding tool to carefully, actually, I think my tweezers might be better. I'm gonna just carefully peel them away, being careful not to scratch any of the paint that's already there. All right, and so just to touch up the little red marks, I'm just gonna take the Artist Loft paint that I use, and I'm just gonna put like barely any on there. And I'm just gonna kind of lightly just kind of paint over it. And good as new. No one will ever know the difference. All right, so now I'm just gonna apply my bow, which is super, super easy. So I'm just going to put some glue. So like, see that I just binded this with like, floral wire. So it's like not professional at all. And then I'm just going to place it on my wreath. My circle. Alright guys, so there you have it. Now you know how to make your very own stencil, and you know, if you want to do like something like this, either as decor just to like lean or to actually hang it, now you know. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, make sure you give me a like and subscribe, and as always, happy crafting and happy holidays!